Hello, Mr. Rubel.
Mr. Rubel's my great grandfather.
Hello, sir.
It's good to see you.
You showed the example about Starbucks there. Starbucks Indonesia, Starbucks Hawaii or something.
Right.
I saw another example of using Twitter accounts. It's Dell. So they have each of their employees. They have Richard at Bell and right. George at Bell. So they are actually mixing their personal tweets, but they're acting as an employee for Bell. So it's like a dual personality in one account. So I want to know, what do you think about it? Is it really a good idea to mix those two personalities, or it's better to be separate? Thank you.
Sure, you're welcome. I personally love that approach. Because what it does is it shows me humans behind the company. And those are Richard Adele and Richard Binhammer. He's a big guy, as is Lionel at Dell. And you build relationships one-to-one with your users. And the users feel like they know somebody at Dell who is going to listen to them, because it's a real human being. And if they have a problem with a Dell computer, they will DM him, they will reply to him. And they have a port into that company. So I think that's extraordinarily effective for anybody who's willing to do that. Wherever I go, though, there's a lot of people who say to me, Steve, my Facebook is my Facebook. It's not for the company. It's only for me and my friends. Those people are never going to do and be a public figure, if you will, like Richard Binhammer at Dell is. They just won't. That's cool. There are extroverts in this world. And there are introverts. And that keeps the world in balance. So, most of the time. So, the extroverts need to always win.
if you compare it to the other approach of having only one official account from Dell, which one do you prefer?
I prefer to have many places, many touch points, because then you create that surface area. And you also pull that through the lens of the personality. But again, if you have nothing, having that corporate Twitter account is better than having nothing. There's other ways to do it too on Twitter through GoTweet, if you've seen that.
Oh, yeah.
So you can have five people tweeting on the same account and have them be personally identified as well. So there's other ways to get around it. But I think it works best when you put really human type. So I love working there.
Okay. Can you believe you're actually. Can you believe we're actually talking to Steve Rubel?
I can't believe it.
We used to spend nights reading your friend feed.
Me too. I can't believe that I'm in Indonesia talking to a group of people who want to hear what I have to say.
He's such a nice guy. Who else?
Dark side, over there. We got two on the dark side. They've been sitting in the dark the whole time. They can't see anything. They need to be enlightened.
See if my number one.
Hello, my name is Iwan from Telkom Indonesia. I would like to ask you about how to prevent the negative aspect of negative campaign maybe in social media. And second...
Yeah, no, your eyes have to adjust.
My knowledge about internet marketing is all about traffic. And how about viral content? Is it part of real engagement that you said before? Maybe that's...
I'm not quite sure I understand the question. So you're saying your question was about traffic, and you're saying that you get more traffic through engagement, is that your question?
Yes.
You can, but I think that... But you said your job is all about traffic, is that what you said?
No, exactly, but one of the things.
Yes. So you're measured based on traffic.
Yes.
Well, yes, engagement can happen with traffic, but the problem is, what if that engagement doesn't take place on your site, but it takes place somewhere else? And so it might not mean traffic. Traffic is one way to measure things, but I think it's becoming a diluted number, because it was much easier when there were a million websites. Yeah, we got a lot of traffic. But now when there's billions of websites and billions of pages, you're not going to win the traffic wars. Might be hard to continue to win. So I think, yes, engagement for sure, it can drive traffic, and there are clear strategies, especially on Twitter and Facebook, that you can implement to drive more traffic to your site. I think, though, you have to ask yourself, the question isn't traffic anymore. Is it the right traffic? Is it the kind of people you want coming to your site? And if you engage those people on social networks, you have a better shot at attracting the right traffic. But I think in the future, you're going to be less concerned about traffic on your site and more about the traffic you get elsewhere. So, am I answering your question?
Yes. For the first question, should we worry about the negative campaign in social media as a company?
Well, anytime you open yourself up to social media, you can open yourself up to the negative. I mean, just as a fact. So you have to look at yourself as a company and you have to say, do we have more to gain than we have to lose? And if we have more to gain, then do it. If you have more to lose, then maybe you don't do it. So only you can really know that. What kind of phone you got there? Looks nice.
Thank you.
Like a hand.
Yes.
Right next to you.
Hi, Steve. My name is Sinta.
Hi, Sinta. I'm Steve.
You mentioned about putting employees front and center as the ambassadors for the social network marketing.
Yes.
Should we, as a company, put some boundaries so that the personalities of these people does not overshadowing the brand that they were trying to market?
So that's a really good question. What kind of company is it?
Telco.
It doesn't start with T and end with I. T-I, the first two initials, does it? Okay, well, I'll let you hold that to yourself. So here's the thing. So where I come from in the United States, we like big personalities, okay? So I look to the sports world, I'm going to use the U.S. example, but I can probably pick anything. So in the U.S., we like stars. So we like, let's say basketball, okay? We like that we have LeBron James. Everyone know LeBron James, okay? Or Kobe Bryant, okay? And that he's a superstar, right? Sometimes he overshadows the Lakers because he's a well-known star. Or David Beckham, what team do you play for? I know he's hurt right now, but what team? Well, like now he's not playing for, but he's going to play for England, right? Who's the big star in Arsenal? Rooney? Rooney's on Manchester or Arsenal? Manchester. All right, I'm getting it. Okay, so Rooney is well-known as a star of Manchester. If he goes down, that overshadows the sometimes the corporate strategy. Okay, like that.